Greetings, my name is Chris M. Sprague, and today we're going to be talking about BuzzMe.in, the free web conferencing and web meeting platform that you need to go out and try and start using today. And why do I say this? Well, you can read the text on the screen just as easily as I can, so let me give you my why. The reason I love using BuzzMe.in is it saves me time, saves me stress, saves me frustration, and most of all, it saves me money. And when a product or platform can do those four things, it's at least worth you taking a shot at trying it. I'm sure once you try it, you're going to love it. So in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to touch on these eight things. We're going to give you a brief overview, show you everything from customized layouts to shortcut keys, whiteboarding questions, all in between, and provide a little tutorial on how to use those things. Now, the platform is very simple, so a tutorial probably isn't needed, but let's face it, a helping hand and a guide along the way is always good and can help speed things up even more. And the great thing is you'll be able to watch this video from within BuzzMe.in when you go in and sign up and start creating your first free room. Let's go ahead and dive right in. The first thing on the list here, customized layouts. Let me show you what the default layout looks like that you're going to see when you go into BuzzMe.in. So when you go in and you create your room in BuzzMe.in, this is what you're going to see. You're going to see a way to get, you're going to see a link to get back to this video, plus these other things that are going to be on your screen. And this is what you and all your attendees will see. One of the powerful things about BuzzMe.in, one of the things that I love the most about this product is the ability to change the way this layout looks with one click of a button. You know, if you use those other software, those other platforms and this other software, that other software that's out there, and we all have, you know, it takes at least a couple of seconds or maybe sometimes a couple of minutes to get everything looking quite right. BuzzMe.in has solved that problem by creating these layouts. So you go down here to the lower right-hand corner, click the default layout button, and you have your preset layouts. So you can change the way the screen looks with the click of the button. Say you want to use BuzzMe.in just for a video chat with a business partner. Boom, click video chat, and now you're up, and you have just the webcams available, which for a video chat is all you need. Say you're in the middle of that video chat and you want to kind of flip it to a meeting and want to show a little presentation, maybe you want to do a little chat at the same time, boom, you flip it, the presentation window comes back up, the chat window comes back up, and your webcams are on the left-hand side there in two boxes. Now, yes, you can still move all these around. You can see the minimize and maximize, and you can move these things around. However, these default layouts make it simple and effective for you to get to where you are to where you need to go, which is getting your information out and interacting with your attendees. And at the end of this video, I'm going to show you a real quick trick which makes this feature even more powerful. Let's go ahead and flip back to the default layout and talk a little bit about presenters. Now, any software like this that's powerful needs to have the ability and the way to switch presenters. And here, very, very simple to switch presenters. So we've got two people in the meeting right now, me and Joe. And say I want to make Joe a presenter. I go highlight Joe's name. You'll notice this little presenter box comes up and a bubble pops up underneath that says click to make presenter. I click the little presenter icon. All of a sudden, the bar that was on the left and the bar that was on the bottom go away. If I flip over and look at what Joe's looking at, he now can access the bar on the right and the slide bar and everything else that was on the bottom. Real simple. Say I want to take control back from Joe and I want to be the presenter again. I highlight my name, presenter icon comes available. I click on the presenter icon and boom, now I can control the slides and now I have the whiteboarding functionality back, which we will talk about in a few minutes. The next thing I want to touch on is presentation uploads, because let's face it, when you're doing a web meeting, you're probably going to want some sort of presentation, even if it's only a couple of slides with text on it, maybe a video, something like that. So we've made it easy and simple and very effective for you to go ahead and upload presentations and get them into the screen quick and easy. So you come down here, click on the upload presentation button. You get this screen that pops up. This says add files to your presentation. Click the select file button. Now, when you do this on your screen, when you're in there, you will end up seeing the file selection box. You can't see it because it's not shared right now. Once you select the file, your file name will pop up here. Once the file name pops up there, you click on upload. In a couple of seconds, it'll upload. It'll convert it, and boom. Your presentation will be available right in the main presentation window. It's just that simple, quick, and easy to upload a presentation. So now let's talk about polls. When you're doing a presentation, a lot of times you want to get interaction, you want to get feedback from your audience, and maybe want to take a poll. Like say, for example, we're here in this presentation, we're going through, and we hit this slide and talking about core problem and consequences. And so we want to take a poll to see what our audience thinks, which is more important, understanding a core problem or understanding the consequences. Well, to take a poll, we just come down here. Did a little bar chart, and when we put our mouse over it, it's going to say start a poll. We click on that. We have these predefined options, yes, no, you can read them on the screen as well as I can. And down here at the bottom, we have custom poll. So let's go ahead and click on custom poll so we can type in the exact poll that we want. So say we're going to say core problem and consequence. Core problem, consequence, and I'm a baby both. We'll give them an option, option C. So we go ahead and click on start poll, and you notice core problem, consequence, and both all pop up. Now you don't want to click on publish yet. Notice how it says waiting for responses. Let me show you what your attendees will see. Your attendees are going to see this. They'll see the boxes down at the bottom, core problem, consequence, both. They get a chance to choose. Then say Joe, the attendee, says, I think core problem is the most important. Boom, he clicks on core problem. The choices go away. He's registered his vote. You come back on your screen. You see core problem has now one vote. Consequence and both have none. Done, because he's the only attendee there. So you know that there's no more responses you can get. You then click on publish. When you click on publish, two things happen. One, it shows up as an annotation down here in the actual presentation. And two, it shows up in the chat window. This is really important, and the reason this is so important that it shows up in both places is because you might not want to leave this as an annotation on the actual presentation, because it might clutter it up, or you might just not want to see it there. If you don't want to see it there anymore, all you have to do is move your mouse to the right and get these options available. This little undo annotation button, click that, and boom, it removes it. And this kind of leads us into a quick discussion on whiteboarding. The beautiful part is that this presentation is, I'll say, automatically whiteboarded, which means you can mark it up using these. You can use a pencil, a square. You can use whatever you want. You can change the color. You can change the font size. You might want to delete all annotations, or maybe you want to zoom in on something. I think this is really powerful because sometimes, let's face it, you want to show a little extra emphasis. So you click on the pan and zoom. You zoom in. Maybe you want to go ahead and put a circle around because and say, see, because this. Maybe you want to point something out to people, draw their attention to it. With the whiteboarding functionality built in, makes it easy, simple, and quick to do, which is the most important thing, because the last thing you want to do when doing a presentation like this is have a whole bunch of overhead that you have to play around with. This gives you the basics to quick, simple, easy to get to where you need to be. Other than that, that's pretty much the whiteboarding. I'm going to make a couple annotations here. Let's say we want to make a let's say we want to add some text to it. Hello world. Or we could do the typical foo and bar. And in the end, we're all done, and say we want to clear it. We just go ahead and click the X and we clear the annotations. One last thing I want to show you about presentations is down here at the bottom where you can click select a slide. The nice thing about this is it gives you a little preview of the slide coming up to make it easy to select. So we've gone through a whole lot so far. We only have a couple more things left to go. Next thing is questions. Now, any software that's powerful needs to have a way to allow the user, allow the attendee to ask a question without really interrupting the presenter. BuzzMe.in gives you that. So say Joe has a question, it's burning on his mind, but you're off presenting and you're in a role and Joe doesn't want to interrupt you. All Joe has to do is come down here and click on this hand. He can choose a status, say, hey, I'm happy about something, or if he has a question, click on the raise hand status. Hand pops up in his window and hand pops up in your window so that you know Joe has something to say. Pretty neat, huh? Then all you got to do is when you clear it, once you've answered Joe's question, boom, click on the hand and it goes away. Now let's talk a little bit about chat. Other than the public chat, which is self-explanatory, if you click on the options here, you can choose a private chat. Say you want to send a note to Joe. You click on Joe's name, say, hey Joe, Click on send, and then on Joe's tab, he has this little yellow orange box that pops up with your name in it, or tab that pops up with your name in it. He clicks on it, he sees your message, and he says, "Hey, Chris." And now you guys are having a private conversation in the middle of your meeting. Simple, powerful, effective. BuzzMe.in does it all for you. The last thing before we get to that little trick I wanted to show you is the shortcut keys. Now, there's a ton of shortcut keys in here, so I don't have at my command the time today to go and explain all of them. I just wanted to alert you that they're there, so that when you're in using BuzzMe.in and when you create your room and you go in, you can look around and take a look at all the different shortcut keys. You just click on shortcut keys, and you go ahead, boom, and you go through all of them, and you see what functions are available to you. Once again, a very powerful feature that's added in to BuzzMe.in. And now it's time for me to show you that trick I was telling you about earlier when it comes to layouts. So we're in a meeting, we're in a web presentation, everybody comes into the default view. We can see we have the same view. I'm flipping back and forth between my view and Joe's view. And say for the bulk of the meeting, I'd rather not have it be the default layout. I'd rather have it as a presentation meeting. So I switch mine to presentation. The problem is, Joe still sees the original view, which is what happens on every other software platform that I know of that I've used out there, and probably all the ones you've used too. Well, say we want every one of our attendees to see exactly the same thing. We've got two options. We could tell people to flip the view, and some people will and some people won't. Or BuzzMe.in's got a very easy way for you to take care of it. All you gotta do is come down here to the lower right hand corner, click on this little button that says apply current view to all viewers, current layout to all viewers. You click on that and boom, Joe sees exactly what you see. It saves you time, saves you stress, saves you the frustration of having to talk people through it, and ensures that everybody is seeing exactly what you're seeing. Because let's face it, when you're doing a presentation, when you're doing a meeting, the most important thing, the most critical thing is for people to see exactly the same thing you're seeing. BuzzMe.in's got an easy way to make sure that happens. So this has just been a quick video. Once again, we talked about 8 things within BuzzMe.in. I hope after seeing this video, if you're not already on BuzzMe.in watching it as a tutorial, I hope you come on over to BuzzMe.in, take a look, create a free meeting room, start meeting with BuzzMe.in. Once you try it, you're going to love it. And until we see you on the inside, make it an epic day.